A lot of people think that you have to know coding when it comes to doing SEO. They fear that they won't be able to optimize their site because they know nothing about HTML or coding, and they're gonna get paralyzed. But there's a lot of tools that can help you with the really important parts of SEO without you having to lift a finger when it comes to coding. Hey everyone, I'm Neil Patel, and today I'm gonna break down how to make your website SEO-friendly when you can't even code. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel. And if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. So the first way that you can make your website more SEO friendly is schema generators. The importance of structured data continues to grow more and more as you see Google leaning towards more mobile friendly, rich snippets, and voice search efforts. Now that you know why schema is important, well, there's another interesting thing that you need to know. By having it, it can drastically increase your CTR compared to your competitors when they don't have it. Especially, let's say you're selling a product and you have the review rating there and people know yours is a 5-star out of 5 based on 500 reviews versus your competitors, they don't have any of that data in their schema markup, they're probably gonna get less clicks than you. However, if you don't have any experience coding, you're probably like, wait, how do I do this? Well, luckily, there are schema generating tools out there that can help you out. Here's some good ones. Google Structured Data Helper. This tool allows you to visually tag elements on your web page and generate proper markup. Another one is Schema Markup Generator. This tool helps you create code that you can simply copy and paste into your site's HTML. The next thing you need to do is start leveraging XML sitemap generators. And you're probably wondering, why is a sitemap important for SEO? Well, if Google has a hard time crawling your site, then those pages may not be indexed. If Google has an easy time crawling your site, you're more likely to have more pages that are indexed, and more of those pages are probably gonna rank higher. Now, with a sitemap, what this is doing is telling Google, hey, here's a whole list of all the pages that are on my site, and please index them. They may not index them all, but you got a better chance of them crawling your site and indexing it. If you can't figure out how to create an XML sitemap, no worries, they're Screaming Frog. This is a software that can help you with a variety of SEO activities, including creating XML sitemaps. If you're on WordPress, you can just use the Yoast SEO plugin, but if you're not on WordPress, check out Screaming Frog because this can help you. And once you generate that sitemap, make sure you submit it to Google Search Console because this will tell Google, hey, go crawl all these pages. The next thing you need to do is create a robots.txt file. So why does a robots.txt file matter? Well, they tell robots which pages they should be crawling and which pages they shouldn't. Do you want Google to be crawling your sensitive pages that you don't want users to touch? Of course not. Let's say you have pages out there that you're continually improving, but you don't want Google to see, and you're using for, let's say, social media campaigns or paid advertising campaigns. These are all pages that you want to block through robots.txt. Now, Internet Marketing Ninjas has a very simple robots.txt generator tool that you should check out. You can just plug in any of the pages you want, index in Google all the pages that you want excluded, and they'll create something for you. You just upload, and boom, you're off to the races. Next, you need a CDN to speed up your time. Faster sites create better user experiences, and those pages rank better on Google. Google has even said that they look at a load time of a site to determine its ranking as well. So CDN is a content delivery network, and what that does is put your site throughout servers all across the world. And there's this company called Cloudflare that helps put your site on all the servers throughout the world. Now, what's cool about Cloudflare is they have a free plan. So you can get started for free, and this can help improve your load times, which in theory will help improve your rankings over time as well without you being a developer. Next, I want to go over SEO and content optimization tools. A lot of times I receive the question, how can I optimize my site for SEO? Well, if you're not sure on how to optimize your site for specific keywords, having a tool to help you optimize your site can be a virtual lifesaver. From things like keyword density, keyword placement, to readability score, there's a lot of tools out there that can make your life easier. If you're on WordPress, I recommend that you check out Yoast or RankMath. They're both really good tools and it allows you to control all the main areas of your site without you needing to be technical. From title, to slug, to metadata, to making sure that your page follows basic SEO guidelines. In essence, it does what you need to do without you needing to know SEO or how to code. Now, if you're still struggling with your SEO, you can always check out my ad agency, Neil Patel Digital. If you have any questions, leave a comment below and I'll answer it. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe, share this video, like it.